This video demonstrates how to report an issue through your ServiceNow instance and check on reported issues. Click an item to go directly to that topic, or continue watching to see them all. Joe employee is having a bad day. He tries to email a quote to a client but gets an error. So he tries to fax it, but the fax machine won't send. Defeated, he returns to his office and slumps into his chair, which collapses beneath him. These mishaps occur every day in the workplace, though usually not to the same guy. Poor Joe. He wants to get these issues resolved quickly and easily, with the least possible impact on his work. Fortunately, all he needs to do is report these issues through simple forms on his ServiceNow instance, and incident records will be generated automatically to kick off the incident management process whereby issues are handled and resolved. Let's see how it works. The ServiceNow user interface is highly customizable, so your experience may differ from that shown in this video, but the concepts are the same. Depending on how your instance is configured and your roles in the system, there are several ways you might report issues. For example, we're logged in as Joe employee, and some options are available right here on our homepage. All of these items can also be accessed through the service catalog, a collection of products and services available to the logged in user, organized by categories in one central location. Here are the catalog items in the Can We Help You category. Several are geared toward reporting issues. Report an issue, create incident, report performance problem, and report outage. If an item has a preview link, clicking it provides additional information about the item. This looks like the right place to deal with our email issue. Let's see if it's listed here. Yes, it is. We aren't sure if all operations are slow, so we'll select one or more. We just provide some detail and submit the form. This automatically opens an incident, which we can track from our homepage. Let's report our other issues, starting with the faulty fax machine. This form is different from the other one. Your organization may have separate forms for various types of issues, and they may be interchangeable for some issues. For example, it looks like we could have reported the email issue on this form. We just enter a description and any additional information that may be helpful. And here's our incident. If your instance is set up with a service portal, you can also report and track issues that way. Service portals provide an intuitive interface for end users to access specific platform components. This looks promising. We'll create an incident to report our broken chair. The asterisk means this is a required field. We can't submit the form until all required fields are filled in. We can borrow a chair, so we'll rate the urgency low. If you attach a file, it's a good idea to mention it so that the person working the incident doesn't overlook it, and explain it if necessary. We submit this and get a response from the system. We can track our open incidents from the service portal homepage. Here's the incident number and other details, and this gives us an idea of how long it may be before we get a response. If we're viewing an incident at the same time it's being updated, the updates are displayed dynamically. We can add comments to the incident at any time until it's closed. By default, the system sends you an email notification whenever a new comment is added to the incident by anyone other than yourself, and responding to the email adds another comment to the incident. Here's the comment Joe just sent. Because the service portal opened in a new browser tab, we just close it when we're done. We can also track our open incidents here on the home page or through the Incidents module. Depending on your instance's configuration, related search results may be displayed based on terms in the incident's short description field. In some cases, these may help you resolve the issue on your own, but none of these resources can fix our broken chair. The incident looks different than it did in the service portal, but the content is the same. When the incident is resolved, we receive an email notification. If we're able to verify that the issue has been resolved to our satisfaction, we can go into the incident and close it. If we can't verify it immediately, for example, in this case we haven't yet received the new chair, the incident will close automatically after a predetermined period of time. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community. For cost-effective training solutions, contact ServiceNow Education Services.